sensational summer showdowns highlight the USWA Challenge this week. Hollywood John Tatum says he's a changed man, but without Tessa or the Southern Heavyweight title, he's been a man in search of the gold and the girl. Today, he faces superstar Bill Dundee in a showdown for the Southern title. Outside the ring, inside the ring, Jeannie has been wreaking havoc on gentleman Chris Adams. Chris's wife, Tony, has eyed a showdown. Today, it's a mixed tag team war with stunning Steve Austin and Jeannie against gentleman Chris Adams and Tony. So come on, what are you waiting for? The USWA Challenge is next. Three big matches, three main events on this week's edition of the USWA Challenge. Hello everyone, Craig Johnson ringside at the Sportatorium. And tonight we will see a Southern Heavyweight Championship matchup as superstar Bill Dundee takes on Hollywood John Tatum. Superstar Bill Dundee joined by Tessa. We'll see the final showdown as Kerry Von Erich takes on Maniac Matt Bourne, who is joined by his manager, Percival Pringle III. And a mixed tag match as Tony joins gentleman Chris Adams to take on stunning Steve Austin with Jeannie. Three main events coming your way. We get it started next with a Southern Heavyweight Championship on USWA Challenge.
You don't need a Tetris shot.
Tetris.
How do you even Tetris size?
Square, rectangle, trapezoid, Tetrazoid.
Nintendo introduces Tetris.
Put a piece here, put a piece there.
Use your thumbs, use your eyes.
Find yourself Tetris-sized.
Now you're playing with power.
Clark Kellogg started school yesterday.
Welcome to New York.
And today, he's wanted by the FBI.
Believe you know of Carmine Sabatini.
The boss's daughter.
Is your father in the house now?
Men named Guido.
Forget about it.
And a family he can't disappoint.
I don't see how I could say no.
Marlon Brando.
I want to hear yes.
Matthew Broderick.
Yes.
The freshman.
I don't know why I'm so happy.
Rated PG. Now playing at a theater near you.
They're wild. They're reckless.
Hey, ready!
They're insane. But at Air America...
I don't want to crash twice in one day.
Don't worry. I crash better than anyone I know.
That's company policy. Mel Gibson.
Why don't you go first?
No, I don't want to go first.
Hey, okay, I'll go first.
Robert Downey Jr.
No, I don't want to go second.
All right.
Air America. This film has not yet been rated. Starts Friday, August 10th at a theater near you.
On this edition of the USWA Report, we preview tonight's main event as gentlemen Chris Adams and Tony take on stunning Steve Austin with Jeannie.
I don't know about taking on. Obliterate would be a better word. You know, Steve Austin, you used to be a friend of mine. You used to be in my wrestling school. What happened to you? Your head grew too big. What happened to you, Jeannie? You used to be my wife, and now you're interfering in my matches for no reason. The divorce was final. Everything was final, but you keep on poking your nose, and you've poked it in so much that tonight I'm gonna take care of it personally.
Jeannie, I've got one thing to say to you right now, and you better listen. Be here, be on time, because I'm sick of you, I'm sick of your talking. I've had enough. And I'm gonna stop it right now. Can't wait.
It's too mixed sweet. Tag team action, and you're gonna get it.
There is Tessa, looking lovelier than ever as she makes her way to ringside with the Southern Heavyweight Champion from Down Under, superstar, Bill Dundee. America's, we can't call them the newest couple anymore because they've been together for some weeks and quite happy. As Tessa helps Bill, and Bill helps Tessa into the ring. Tony Falk is your referee for this championship event on USWA Challenge. And now, John Tatum pleading with Tessa. Tessa's been getting some Federal Express packages, and John Tatum wants to have the house mic. I'll get back to that thought in a little bit.
Tessa, I wrote you poems from the bottom of my heart, and I meant every word of I love you. I've sent you the finest gift money can buy, honey. I've won that title for you, but I know I can see in your eyes. Tonight, I'm gonna beat his brains in, and I'm gonna win that title, and you're gonna come back to me, aren't you? I know, Tessa, I know deep in my heart, you're gonna come back to me tonight.
Well, that was an answer to that part of the question. Hollywood John Tatum, and there is Tessa, and what does that look in the eyes of Tessa mean? And now, oh, a heart-to-heart is broken up with a right hand of Bill Dundee. John Tatum says he's changed, but if you look in the eyes of Hollywood John Tatum, he is a man determined, determined to get back two things, the Southern Heavyweight Championship, and the woman he's talking to there, Tessa. Tessa's been getting some mysterious packages filled with lavish gifts. I don't know if Hollywood John Tatum has been the man sending it or not. Hollywood John Tatum looks into the eyes of Bill Dundee, but Bill Dundee has a message for him. And there it is, the beginnings of the bionic pout from Hollywood John Tatum. Tessa looks on as it's an arm drag by superstar Bill Dundee, putting pressure on the elbow and the shoulder of Hollywood John Tatum. The Southern Heavyweight Champion from down under in Australia. Has the arm bar locked on tight. And now, a boot to the head. And Hollywood John Tatum is a man not only obsessed, but upset. As Tatum sneaks up on Dundee, and now Dundee has a few messages of his own. Right, down you go. And now John Tatum comes out to take a respite at ringside. And now he comes over towards us to maybe have a talk with Tessa. Hollywood John Tatum continues to follow Tessa. And Tessa continues to walk away.
You're gonna come back to me, aren't you?
He says, I'm going to do this one for you.
I know you're going
to
come
back. Well, he wants to get Tessa back. He wants to get the Southern Heavyweight Championship. A title he has owned before. And there you see the look in the eyes. Both grapplers make their way back into the ring. Superstar Bill Dundee, the champion, the challenger, Hollywood John Tatum, they lock up. And once again, Dundee goes to the arm. Dundee puts it back into a chicken wing, putting pressure on the elbow of Hollywood John Tatum, who grimaces in pain, but not giving up. Although he's asked by referee Tony Falk if he wants to. Pressure with that hammerlock turned into a chicken wing here by superstar Bill Dundee.
Tony Falk checks to see if Hollywood John Tatum wants to submit. That's a painful hold. And Bill Dundee has been locked on that arm. Let's take a break right here and be back with more of the Southern Heavyweight Title Match in a minute. Sensational summer showdowns this week on the USWA Challenge. As for the Southern Heavyweight title, Hollywood John Tatum takes on superstar Bill Dundee with Tessa. Plus, it's a mixed tag team war as gentleman Chris Adams with his wife Tony take on stunning Steve Austin and Jeannie.
Tony's the one, she wanted this big showdown here. But I bet you what, I bet she doesn't even show up because she's a coward.
This week on the USWA Challenge. This week, it's a mixed tag team war with gentlemen Chris Adams and Tony against stunning Steve Austin with Jeannie on USWA Challenge. Last time that Tony and Chris Adams faced off in a mixed tag match with stunning Steve Austin and Jeannie, it had a shocking result. Now, the rematch as it's mixed tag team action. Will it be Chris and Tony coming out on top? Or do stunning Steve Austin and Jeannie have a few more tricks? Find out this week on the USWA Challenge. Superstar Bill Dundee eyeing Hollywood John Tatum after Tatum broke the arm bar. Back to the corner they go. Tatum with a roundhouse right. And superstar Bill Dundee may not have expected that from the changed Hollywood John Tatum. And maybe the changed man has gone back to his old ways, trying to get back the lovely Tessa and the title. A series of rights, and Dundee goes down. John Tatum, loving the accolades and the cheers, and there's a nice right from superstar Bill Dundee, saying, okay, if you're gonna take the applause and or the booze, I'm going to give you a message. And that message has size 10 written on it. John Tatum stumbles out of the ring, almost taking down our monitor in the process. And superstar Bill Dundee goes after him. Now, into the stairs. And you're right on top of the action as the action gets almost right on top of our cameraman. Hollywood John Tatum, trouble getting up as superstar Bill Dundee makes his way back into the ring. The lovely Tessa at ringside watching all the action of her man as her man happens to be in charge right now. And now Bill Dundee threatening to take some of the livelihood away from Hollywood John Tatum. Instead, goes into the spinning leg lock. And there is Tessa looking on. What is in those eyes that Hollywood John Tatum says that he saw? Right now, pain in the eyes of Hollywood John Tatum as Bill Dundee has the arm lock, or rather the leg lock, locked on. As the arm of Hollywood John Tatum was reaching out for whatever help may be getting. Pressure on the leg. by superstar Bill Dundee as he stretches out the hamstring and puts pressure on the knee of Hollywood John Tatum. Hollywood John Tatum having trouble with that knee. And oh, a rake of the eyes by Hollywood John Tatum. Now, allegedly, that knee was hurt last week. But Tatum had gotten up and sucker punched superstar Bill Dundee. There's a cover. That's one, but only a count of one as Dundee gets out and saves his title. Dundee with the big boot to the chin, and now the right to the chin, left. He's taking charge, a series of right lefts, but Tatum will not go down. And now, Dundee goes for the crossbody splash, but Tony Falk gets in the way. There's a cover, that's one, that's two, nobody's counting. Tony Falk unable to see the count. Tatum gets up. And now they roll over. He has him down. And once again, Tony Falk is just nailed by superstar Bill Dundee. There's a roll up. Tatum has the trunks. But Falk's counting one, two, three. And we have a new Southern heavyweight champion. Tessa looks on. And John Tatum super kicks Dundee. So Tatum has the Southern heavyweight title back. Now he's going to bleed to Tessa. Tessa turns and walks away.
Tessa
says it's over. Tatum has just super kicked Tessa. This is unbelievable. John Tatum, Well, Bill Dundee looking for Tessa and now sees that Tessa lying down, a victim of the savate kick to the back of the head. And folks, this doesn't look good. Let's take a break while they attend to Tessa. We'll be back. It's Kerry Von Erich against Matt Bourne when we return.
They said it wasn't humanly possible, but now you can have all the power and excitement of Nintendo right in the palm of your hand. Introducing Game Boy. It's portable, it's in stereo, and its games are interchangeable. Plus, Game Boy comes with the outrageous new game, Tetris. And for head-to-head competition, use the revolutionary video link and blow your opponent away. Game Boy, only from Nintendo. Now you're playing with power, portable power.
Hey, thanks, man. Stay cool.
Cynthia, honey, studying should be your highest priority.
Son, hard work builds character.
Students, it is time to leave the frivolity of youth behind.
Oh, yeah? One of life's great kicks, Twix. Oh, yeah.
Where are we heading?
They're wild. They're reckless.
Hey, win it!
They're insane. But at Air America...
I don't want to crash twice in one day.
Don't worry, I crash better than anyone I know.
Oh.
That's company policy. Mel Gibson.
Why don't you go first?
No, I don't want to go first.
Hey, okay, I'll go first.
Robert Downey Jr.
No, I don't want to go second.
All right.
Air America. This film has not yet been rated. Starts Friday, August 10th at a theater near you.
On this edition of the USWA Report, we talk to superstar Bill Dundee. And unfortunately, you're the former Southern Heavyweight Champion.
That's right, but that's not the issue right now, Tatum, and you know what it is. This is all over a woman that you said you loved, brother. It was the closest thing to your heart. Everything you said you did, everything that you was doing for her came from your heart. And we saw what came from your heart, brother, and we know what kind of heart you got. You know, winning belts is one thing. Winning wrestling matches is another. But when you can't go to take your spite out on a woman, that ain't right, Tatum. And whatever it takes, brother, whatever it takes to get you in the ring against me, and I don't care what any kind of match it is, it's going to take place, brother. The belt, I would like to get it back. But the issue is at stake right now is Miss Tessa's honor. I believe that young lady did kind of believe what you were saying, because women's that way. And you took advantage of it. In your twisted little mind, you thought you had changed. Well, you haven't changed, sport, but take this to the bank. You and me's going to fight again, Tatum, and that's a promise from me to you, sport, so take it to the bank.
262 pounds of modern-day warrior from Denton County, Texas, Kerry Von Erich. This will be the final showdown as he takes on Maniac Matt Bourne in a heated rivalry that is about to have a heated finish. There he is, the modern day warrior. Meeting with the accolades of the crowd here at the Sportatorium. And the music plays for Maniac Matt Bourne, getting ready for the last showdown. No return matches. This will be it. And Jerry Von Erich over talking to referee Bronco Lubitsch to make sure that nothing goes astray in this, the final showdown. Well, the ringettes are making their way, and we're ready for the appearance of Maniac Matt Bourne with his manager, Percival Pringle III. And I see Percy, but I don't see Matt. Well, we'll have to find out. Maybe I can ask Percy what's going on here. Percival Pringle III making his way to ringside.
I'll tell you where he is.
And would you mind telling us where Mr. Bourne is?
Why don't you ask Horseface where Mr. Bourne is? I don't know who you think you are. Just because your daddy's Fritz Von Erich and you got all this money and you was born with a silver spoon in your mouth, you think you're something, don't you? What I want to know, who do you know in the travel business that can have Matt Bourne put off the airplane in Nashville, Tennessee? He just called me and said that his plane was grounded and they made him get off the plane in Nashville. And that's where he is right now. And it's your fault. What are you laughing about? It's a very serious situation. Let me tell you one thing, Horseface Kerry. He might be in Nashville right now, but he's coming to Dallas. He's going to be here, whether it's Friday, whether it's next Friday, he's coming. And when he does, he's going to kick your pony boy face all over this building. What do you think about that?
Well, let's see what Kerry thinks about
Let
that.
Let me tell you something, Tubby Tuba.
Because Matt Bourne has a scheduling problem on an airplane, that ain't my problem. And I signed for a wrestling match. And if Matt Bourne's not here, it's going to be you.
Oh! Percy may wish he was high above the ring on a swing. He tries to get out, but he has nowhere to run, nowhere to hide, as it's the modern day warrior taking a piece of hide off Percy Pringle III. And Percy ducks. Terry went for the discus punch and got nothing but iron. Percival Pringle III trying to take advantage of the injured Terry Von Erich.
And Percy doesn't see what's coming. He may wish he hadn't been there.
Oh, there it is. The Iron Claw. Will it go on the blonde locks of Percival Pringle?
He's got it locked in.
And here comes Gary Young and devastation. Terry Von Erich being triple teamed by the Dog of War. And now from the back, here's Billy Joe Travis and Jeff Jarrett.
Percy Pringle III.
Percy Pringle takes an exit. And we will take an exit too. There you see a very happy Terry Von Erich along with Jeff Jarrett and Billy Joe Travis. When we come back, we'll get you set up for today's main event. USWA wrestling power can be fundraising power for your nonprofit organization. Any nonprofit organization can have the wrestling action from the USWA do the fundraising for you. Enjoy your own card featuring the stars of the USWA in action while experiencing the fundraising benefits for your nonprofit organization. Call our events coordinator Monday through Friday, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Central Time at 214-565-9217. On this edition of the USWA Report, we talk to the new Southern Heavyweight title holder, Hollywood John Tatum, but that's not what I want to talk to you about. What kind of business do you have
kicking Tessa in the back of the head. That was despicable.
You know, that's what you want to talk about. But what I want to talk about is, you know, when it gets late at night, Tessa, and it's real cold, the only thing you can snuggle up to is a whole bunch of money. And that's what this represents, Tessa, a whole bunch of money. You know, I don't know what must have been wrong with me. Tessa, you remind me of my old days. When I went out to the bars at 8 o'clock, I'd find me a girl, and she was pretty. About 10 o'clock, she was real pretty. At 2 in the morning, she was gorgeous. And at 10 o'clock the next morning, she's a dog. And Tessa, I just woke up, and it's 10 in the morning. Bow wow, you're a dog.
In case you missed it last week, let's take a look one more time at the history between Stunning Steve Austin and Gentleman Chris Adams. Will it come to a stunning conclusion tonight, or will it be a more gentlemanly conclusion? Or will we not even have the matter settled? The girls will be in the ring. Why are they in the ring? Let's let you take a look right here. He's gonna try to finish Adams off. Down to the back of the neck. Adams writhing in pain. He's got the chair right across the back of the neck.
What is he gonna do now?
He comes down right on the back of the neck. Adams
with a metal chair, Craig. He's gonna do it again, it looks like.
The third time, down on the back of the neck. That can paralyze a man.
Sweet Jeannie smiling now.
Oh, again. He throws the chair down.
Chris is writhing with pain out on the floor. He's hitting in the back of that neck with that chair.
Look at Jeannie! Look at Jeannie! Adding insult to injury, Stunning Steve Austin thinks he has the job done as he and Jeannie make their way up the aisle. Gentleman Chris Adams, who was too injured even to come to the TV taping, and he hit him on the back of the neck. Steve Austin hits Adams on the back of that injured neck, and he goes after the neck again. A boot to the back of the neck of Gentleman Chris Adams by Stunning Steve Austin. And now he's trying to take the brace off. He's got it off. That neck is unprotected. Remember, he had hit him with a chair. Almost. He was trying to break his neck, and now he's got him wrapped up in the ropes. Chris Adams helpless in the ropes. Double axe handle to the back. And now here comes Jeannie. Jeannie is stepping into the ring. Jeannie, the ex-wife of Gentleman Chris Adams. Adams says that's all in the past, but Jeannie apparently harboring a few memories from there. Austin taking charge, and Jeannie mocking Gentleman Chris Adams. Oh, not this again, not this again. Jeannie getting set to slap Gentleman Chris Adams and gets him once and gets him again. She just looking like she enjoys it so much. Is there? The crowd is roaring. It's Tony, it's Tony. Tony Adams coming to the ring. Tony looking mad, gets into the ring. Hello. Look at the firm now. It's Gentleman Chris Adams taking charge, and Tony looks at Jeannie and says, "Lady, you're all mine." And there they go. Austin has his hands and throws Tony away. And Jeannie has just pulled the chair out from underneath me. She throws the chair in, but it goes right to Chris Adams. But Austin pounds on Adams before he can get to the chair.
And now stunning Steve Austin nails Adams on the back. Now in the aisle, it's Tony Adams stalking Jeanne with the kendo stick. And Jeanne is whopping, being whopped by Tony. Tony's been waiting for this. Tony getting some payback. Meanwhile, Steve Austin has nailed Chris Adams, and now Jeanne has the kendo stick. Austin is holding Tony Adams. Jeanne looking like Bo Jackson, getting ready to hit one out of the park, and hits her right across her stomach. Again, Jeanne just nails Tony. And now to the back. Oh, Jeanne now hitting Chris Adams. This is too much. Jeanne just having her way. On this edition of the USWA Report, we talk about our main event. And Jeanne, I think Tony has a few things to say to you and maybe a few things to do to you.
Yeah, Tony's the one. She wanted this big showdown here. But I bet you what, I bet she doesn't even show up because she's a coward. And you people out there are nothing but lowlifers. I am far superior to you. I have royal blood in my veins. She was born on a shrimp boat. She's jealous of me. And you people out there, you're jealous of me because you could never be like me. But I'll tell you what, I am going to show you, Tony. I've got your ribs. I've given Chris a lump in the back of his neck. But when I get you in the ring, you're going to be mine. I promise you that.
Miss Jeanne may be dressed for battle, but are you ready?
Oh, I'm ready. I'm ready this time.
The mixed tag match is coming up. Next on USWA Challenge. The most dangerous pair in wrestling. Jeanne and stunning Steve Austin. And Jeanne is dressed ready for a fight. This a mixed tag bout as it's Jeanne in the ring for the first time taking on stunning Steve Austin. Their opponents, gentlemen Chris Adams and Tony,
And we know that Tony is ready for battle after all the things that Jeannie has done to both Chris and to Tony. Remember little things like hairspray in the eyes? How about the chair to the back of the neck of gentleman Chris Adams from Stunning Steve Austin? And here comes the entrance of gentleman Chris Adams as the music plays. And there you see a hug of confidence there, I guess. And here is Tony, dressed for battle. And the man from Stratford-on-Avon, gentleman Chris Adams. I was telling you about some of the things that happened between these two teams. And I don't think I'm going to have a chance to tell you about much more, because Tony's ready to go. Tony Adams taking care of Jeannie. Gentleman Chris taking care of business. Now, stunning
cut it out right now. I'm going to stop the match before it even starts. Now, we're going to have some order in this match. So stop it right now.
Tony Adams with the warning.
And you get them out until they tag. We're going to have a tag team match.
Just trying to review some of the things that have happened between Jeannie and gentleman Chris Adams. Jeannie has sprayed hairspray into the eyes of Chris Adams. Stunning Steve Austin has done some devious things, such as taking a chair to the back of Chris Adams' neck. Jeannie has put a kendo stick into the ribs of Tony. But finally, all four of them will be in the ring, and Tony wants to start the match against Jeannie. I think the fans want to see the same thing. Jeannie says, hold on. And then tells Steve, I think you should start. And Jeannie's wish seems to be Steve Austin's command. Ah, there is the man with the one and only super kick. Gentleman Chris Adams may be preparing that super kick for stunning Steve Austin. Right now the backdrop is followed by a forearm smash. And now a snapmare into the rear chin lock, putting the pressure on the chin of stunning Steve Austin. Jeannie looking on. Now remember, if Chris Adams tags Tony, Jeannie has to come in, whether she wants to or not. Jeannie comes in, trying to sneak up on the back of gentleman Chris Adams, and slaps him and puts her nails into his eyes. And it was just enough to distract gentleman Chris Adams, as the sleeper hold's being put on by stunning Steve Austin.
You saw the tag.
Stunning Steve Austin putting the pressure on as Tony looks on. Jeannie sees her man on top and in control while Tony gets the fans into it. Adams fighting out. Austin with a chin lock. Adams gets the hold released, is gonna try to reverse it. And a handful of hair by stunning Steve Austin brings gentleman Chris Adams down to the mat, as you see the intense look in the eyes of gentleman Chris Adams. And as you look in those eyes, you wonder what deviousness is behind them.
Oh, yeah.
Tony looks on as stunning Steve Austin
has that chin lock, not quite a sleeper, but that chin lock sunk in deep. Can look at Jeannie saying, oh, please tag me. And once again, a handful of hair prevents Adams from reversing the hold. A warning from referee Tony Falk. The hold still firmly in place by the intense Steve Austin. Speaking of intense, Tony's look is quite an intense one, thank you. The fans pick up the chant once again. Go, Chris, go, led by Tony. And Jeannie looking like she wants the tag from Steve Austin now that he's got the upper hand. Once again, Adams trying to get out of the hold. He gets an elbow to the midsection one more time. That breaks the hold. Gets the forearm, and now a clothesline by stunning Steve Austin back into that chin lock. Stunning Steve Austin has had that pressure hold on for quite a while now.
He's mine!
The confident, stunning Steve Austin in this mixed tag match, although we have yet to see the ladies involved. And now, Austin tags in and slaps gentleman Chris Adams. Let's take a break. We'll be back with more of this action, as hot as it is, when we return.
It's the sound of Motown. 50 certified number one hits by the original Motown superstars. Now for the first time on compact disc.
Baby, everything is all right. Baby, my heart is full of love and desire for you. Jimmy Mac, Jimmy
Mac. My girl.
Better shop around.
Oh, baby, girl, I don't care.
I'll be back.
50 of the hottest Motown super hits on 4 LPs or 3 cassettes, $19.95. And now for the first time on 3 compact discs, $24.95. Order now.
Call 1-800-733-9800 or save COD charges and send just $19.95 for albums or cassettes, $24.95 for compact discs, plus $4 shipping to Motown 25th Anniversary Collection, Box 27, Orchard Park, New York.
You need a Tetris shop.
Tetris.
Have you been Tetris-sized?
Square, rectangle, trapezoid, Tetrazoid.
Nintendo introduces Tetris.
Put a piece here, put a piece there.
Use your thumbs, use your eyes.
Find yourself Tetris-sized.
Now you're playing with power.
Adams has been worn down since taking the upper hand early in the match. Since then, stunning Steve Austin has had control. There you see the oh-so-dangerous Jeannie laughing at Tony across the ring because she knows her man is in control. Adams trying to slip out of that chin lock, gets out, may have the upper hand. He has control. Austin off balance, a handful of hair, but this time Tony Falk saw it. Release the hold, says Tony Falk. And Austin does just for a minute second. Austin goes over and tags Jeannie.
But Chris Adams gets away. And Jeannie, here's the ex-wife of Chris Adams. And look at this. Jeannie is being carried to the corner. And there awaits Tony. It's payback time. Jeannie trying to escape. And she hits Tony in that injured rib. Remembered when she brought that kendo stick in. And now Stunning Steve Austin's going to come in and try to lay some punishment on himself. That injured rib that Jeannie had hit with a kendo stick. But now some punishment being doled out by gentleman Chris Adams. He sends Austin to the rope and nails him with a clothesline. The back of Steve Austin's head hits the canvas as now Adams looks on at the fallen Steve Austin. The crowd is calling for the one and only super kick. Will we get to see it here? Over the top rope, the momentum of Stunning Steve Austin takes him over after that roundhouse right by gentleman Chris Adams. Now off the apron, Austin hits the ground. Jeannie looks on concerned, but right now it's Chris Adams in charge. Sends Austin back into the ring. And you hear the fans yelling for the super kick once again. To the top row goes gentleman Chris Adams. Measuring the elbow, comes down, no! Stunning Steve Austin. Stunning Steve Austin, who has done so much. The gentleman Chris Adams trying to injure his neck. Now it's Adams going to work on the neck of Stunning Steve Austin. Jeannie getting involved, and there they go! And now, Adams throws out Austin. Outside of the ring, while the girls go at it inside, over on the near side, it's Chris Adams. Adams sets up Austin, and Adams hits the post. Austin, the bell rings, no, Austin. Austin going for the pile driver, nails the pile driver. If that neck is injured the slightest bit, Chris could really be hurt now. Austin grabs Tony. Jeannie maybe kissing Tony goodbye. Remember, Jeannie had injured those ribs earlier, but now she's going to work on the face of the lovely Tony. Three slaps as the ex-wife. Oh, now she's going to work on the ribs. Austin slugs Tony Falk. He's out of control. This is just too much. And now Austin tries to tie up Tony in the ropes and does. Tony is absolutely helpless as Jeannie goes to work on Tony, alternating between the face and the ribs. Meanwhile, Austin goes over to the injured Chris Adams, picks him up and throws him into the ring. Adams' neck may very well be injured. After that pile driver, not another pile driver! Austin has just gone wild. Tony is tied up, and now Jeannie trying to hit Chris in the neck, but Tony gets Jeannie away from the situation. Meanwhile, Austin goes up to the top rope. Austin goes up to the top rope. Austin ready to come down. Austin goes on top of Chris, and Austin! Austin comes down on both of them. Tony down on top of Chris to try to save him, but Austin comes down on both of them. And now Austin shoves the referee out. Both of them are injured, and Jeannie comes in.
Oh, yeah. and mocks the fallen Tony and the fallen Chris. As you see, Steve Austin and Jeannie just looking at the conquered, so to speak. And now Jeannie tries to injure Tony even more. Stunning Steve Austin and Jeannie make their exit. And we will wrap up this edition of the USWA Challenge when we return. Still doling out the punishment to the fallen Tony and to gentleman Chris Adams as help is coming in from the back. Has Steve Austin and Jeannie gone out of control or what? Well, join us next week. We'll give you a status report on Tony and gentleman Chris Adams. But I have a feeling we haven't seen the last of this. In addition, what of the Southern Heavyweight title? Hollywood John Tatum has it, but kicking Dessa? Plus, I think Kerry Von Erich gave Percival Pringle a message, and that message was, bring Matt Bourne to me. It's been an action-packed 60 minutes. Join us next week here on The Challenge when we'll have even more action. It'll be hard to top this one, but we will. For our entire crew here at the Sportatorium, I'm Craig Johnson. Have a great week. And join us next week right here on the USWA Challenge.
Saturday night, August the 18th at the Oil Palace.